I'm fascinated by how one can use the web to tell historical narratives, how you can use it to tell stories, and whether, and let me just posit this idea in your mind, whether a link is an interpretation. Okay, so keep that in mind as I go through this. We talk about the urban web and the city as hypertext because, in fact, that's the way I think of cities. And I think of that cities for a number of reasons. Most have to do with the work I've done on the encyclopedia. Let me give a shameless plug for the book. I have to say, the book designer was one of the great people of all times. He won prizes for the design of this book. It's a real testimony to Mike Green with the University of Chicago Press that the book looks so good. And we're going to talk a little bit about the encyclopedia online. And Harlan Wallach was the designer here. You can see the resemblance between the book and the online version. The encyclopedia really was the brainchild of Ann Keating, who brought the idea to the Newberry. And Ann and Jim talked about how they might want to do an encyclopedia, and then they came and asked me whether I wanted to do an encyclopedia. It seemed like a wise thing to do. I was then in Cleveland, and the idea of coming to Chicago a lot appealed to me. I then immediately took a job in Los Angeles, and the idea of flying to Chicago that much had less appeal. But nonetheless, we decided, and we worked on this for a long time, that we wanted to create an encyclopedia. And once they brought me on, was going to be electronic work as well as print work and the University of Chicago Press well along with that. That we wanted to build an Encyclopedia of Chicago, and these were going to be our underlying principles. Now, one of the things that will be clear as I talk about this is these are what we decided our principles were, and we're able to state them clearly at the very end of putting the book together. We all had a bit of a sense of that along the way, but we wanted to have a commitment to a vision of a metropolitan area, and the metropolitan area was key, not just Chicago, but the larger metropolitan area, whose past, present, and future rest on the principle of interdependence. We had a commitment to create a reference book comprising more than discrete frames of information about individual topics. It should represent a synthesis of a century of scholarship in urban history in general and in Chicago in particular. A commitment to an intellectual design influenced by the simultaneous creation of the electronic encyclopedia that places a premium on thinking about links, structures, and the malleability of categories. And a commitment to creating a comprehensive reference work for members of the general public, for secondary school students, as well as scholars of urban history, for lifelong residents in the Chicago area, and for real and virtual visitors. So that was our goal. It was an ambitious goal. We'd like to think we lived up to at least part of it. But you can kind of already see in there that kind of notion of the city as the web, the links, the kind of all these different ways, different audiences